Te tenemos toda la información. Michael B. Jordan y Sylvester Stallone nos cuentan sobre los nuevos personajes en Creed 2. Te mostraremos un detrás de cámaras de las películas Escape Room y Glass. Y conoce cuál es la nueva comedia de Jennifer Aniston. Esto y mucho más hoy en Más que Cine.
Y así arrancamos una nueva semana con lo último del mundo del cine. Bienvenidos, yo soy Alex Medela y vamos a arrancar con un estreno, una película que se demoró un poquito de llegar a nuestro territorio, pero finalmente la tendremos en pantalla. Familia al instante, que cuenta con las actuaciones de Mark Wahlberg y también Rose Byrne. Vamos a ver un detrás de cámaras donde el director nos cuenta por qué se inspiró a hacer esta historia basada en su vida.
Well, we had been talking for a long time about whether or not we wanted to have kids. And I just made this joke of like, God, I'm starting to feel on the old side of it. And why don't we just adopt a five-year-old and it'll be like I got started 5 years ago. And she immediately said, you know, I would really consider that. And I said, yeah, I was really joking.
Once we decided to move forward, it was scary and overwhelming, but we were really open to whatever came our way.
We went through some really tough times, the kids adjusting to us, us adjusting to them, but not just adjusting to them, but just adjusting to being parents in general, because we went from zero kids to three kids literally overnight. I felt like so much of what we went through was funny. So I thought, yeah, couldn't we make a comedy that really shows how this really works?
Do you like the Clippers?
Well, I'm more of a Lakers fan.
Oh no!
You hit me because I like the Clippers.
The Clippers are awesome. They were smart for trading Blake Griffin. Their best player.
The idea isn't for people to see the movie and then run out and adopt kids. I mean, that would be wonderful, but I feel like when people have biological kids, it's very, very easy to picture babies and Little League and graduation and prom. But when people think about kids in foster care, they're thinking ahead of all the sort of hard parts. And what the movie does is it does start with those hard parts, but it also shows what's funny about those hard parts.
Thanks.
I just got my first daddy. Oh, what the?
You suck!
I want some of that.
Hey, honey, can I help you with anything?
No.
En esta temporada de premios, las películas y series de Netflix están dando mucho de qué hablar. Y una de ellas es Dumpling, una película que cuenta con la actuación de Jennifer Aniston. Aquí les presentamos uno de sus primeros avances para que ustedes vayan a verla, porque ya está disponible.
I know how I'm gonna survive my mom's pageant season. She already started her diet.
Oh, really?
Dumpling the other side. Oh, okay, darling, just grab my ankles.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, God.
My name is Willadane Dixon.
Hey, Willadane.
How about?
Tumble out of bed and stumble to the kitchen.
Most people call me Will, except for my mom, who calls me...
Dumpling, I can't be late. This cannot exactly drive itself.
Being a bit of a celebrity around here meant that she was too busy for me.
You've got a hole in your left, by the way.
What? Oh, she didn't listen to me.
Working 9 to 5, what a way to make...
This must be your daughter.
That's my daughter's best friend. This is my daughter, Willadine.
Wow. Okay.
And that's when I decided enough was enough.
I know that look. What's going on?
I think I'm gonna sign up for the pageant.
It's gonna be like a protest in heels.
Willadine Opal.
Hey, y'all. If you're signing up, I am too.
Wait, no, I'm not the Jonah Arc of Fat Girls.
This is gonna be so much fun.
Totally fun.
Pageants are harder than you think.
I'm Rosie Dixon's daughter. It runs in my blood.
We really have to play to our strengths. My strengths are hula hoop and I can tap dance.
He is high and mighty.
No, no, stop it.
I think I know where we can get some help.
What is this place?
It's the closest thing you can get to Dolly Parton around here.
Oh, wow.
Tell me I'm a diva.
Dumpling, I don't understand. Why are you doing this?
It's a protest. We're trying to make a point.
Willadine Dixon, I think you're beautiful. To hell with anyone else who's ever made you feel less than that.
There's nothing in the rules that says big girls need not apply.
I've got myself into something, but now I don't know what I'm doing.
You know that Dolly saying, figure out who you are and do it on purpose.
And here I go.
Viva la revolution, baby.
That was truly a surprise.
Oh.
película también cuenta con la actuación de Daniel McDonald, que también vimos en Bird Box, con una actuación muy divertida que no se pueden perder. Pero ahora vámonos al mundo de la tecnología. Y siempre tenemos problemas con nuestros celulares. Y desde el CES les hablamos de un producto que no puede faltar en su celular.
Estamos acostumbrados a ver en las redes sociales y en YouTube los videos haciendo pruebas para ver la resistencia de las pantallas de sus celulares. Muchos de ellos se rompen, pero ahora eso no va a pasar, porque hay una compañía danesa que se llama Panzer Glass que tiene unos protectores que no son plásticos, sino que son de vidrios. Y hoy vamos a hacer una prueba con Christian, que nos va a enseñar cómo protegen estos protectores su pantalla de celular. Bueno, y este es Christian, que Christian va a hacer la prueba conmigo. Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Muy bien.
Muy bien.
Muy bien.
Muy bien.
¿Qué tiene Panzer Glass? What is so great about Panzer Glass? I told you. No se rompe.
No se rompe.
Y eso es lo que vamos a hacer. Vamos a hacer una demostración. Vamos a enseñar a la gente con un martillo cómo vamos a golpear un teléfono y no se va a romper la pantalla. They all have the screen, yes. The Panzer Glass.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. Vamos a probar ahí. Y tampoco se rompe con un cuchillo ni se raya con el cuchillo, que ahí estamos viendo la demostración.
Well, I really haven't. And you can see the display is still working. Nothing happened.
No le pasa nada a la pantalla.
And what is it's only a piece of glass. You can see that.
Solamente es una pantallita de vidrio. Esto da miedo. This is scary.
Oh, yeah. No.
Hammering a phone. Yeah. Okay, let's do that. Vamos a hacerlo.
More.
Nada. Vamos a ver aquí. Tampoco se raya. No se raya, no se rompe. Y esto es increíble. Esto va a estar en Panamá muy pronto. Ya vimos la demostración de lo que hacen las pantallas Panzer para su celular, Panzer Glass. Pero también vamos a hablarles de la gran gama de productos que tienen. Porque no solamente hay pantallas, también hay covers y hay también incluso pantallas para computadoras. Háblanos un poco de todos los productos.
Bueno, sí, como sabes, Panzer es una compañía europea que trae todos estos cases. Tenemos cases para iPhone 6, iPhone 7, iPhone 8, iPhone X, iPhone XS. Tenemos para Galaxy Note 9, 8, 7, para Xiaomi. Tenemos también para LG, para toda esa variedad de celulares. Y también tenemos lo que son los cases. Estos cases sí lo tenemos para iPhone. Son cases de cristal.
Open, now you see. Now you don't see. Now you see. Now you don't see. And this is why we call that Panzer Glass Dual Privacy Cam Slider. Because it's not only privacy in that way, it also gives you privacy from the inside. So that you can't get spied through the internet. Yeah. Because that's so easy with your Apple ID or whatever, also with Android. No, it's not only Apple.
Anker en Panamá van a tener la línea de Panzer Glass y Panzer Cover para proteger sus celulares. No importa de qué marca sea, usted proteja sus celulares y su inversión.
Panzer Glass está disponible en Panamá en los kioscos Anker. Vayan por el suyo, de verdad. Hay que proteger su celular. Pero vamos a continuar con una historia que muy pronto llega a los cines. A Dog Way Home, una película, por supuesto, con la historia de un perrito que lleva la voz de Bryce Dallas Howard. Conozcamos más de esta aventura.
I'm Bryce Dallas Howard, and I am the voice of Bella in the new movie, A Dog's Way Home. This is the story of the extraordinary lengths a dog will go to in order to get back to their family. Of course, the dog who played Bella would have to be a rescue. We discovered Shelby at a shelter in Tennessee where she had been living in a junkyard. Immediately, you could tell that Shelby was going to take us on an amazing journey. She's incredibly spirited, affectionate, and bright. We found our Bella, and she had no idea how much her life was going to change. Since filming, she's become a therapy dog and knows this is her new purpose, to take care of people and to make them feel loved. Join me and Shelby on our adventure in A Dog's Way Home.
That was the best.
Y ahora vamos a darle inicio a nuestra cobertura del estreno de esta semana, que es Creed 2, que es la recomendación de Más Que Cine. Esta película cuenta con la actuación y regresa a la historia Dolph Lundgren, que lo conocimos como Iván Drago. Veamos este detrás de cámaras que nos cuenta sobre ese regreso.
Creed vs. Drago. This is the fight the whole world wants to see.
Bringing back Ivan Drago and his son Victor made it more intense.
You're much smaller than your father.
It's a loaded situation.
These dudes killed my pops.
Ivan Drago has been established, but we haven't seen him in years.
Ivan was an Olympic champion. He was a hero of the Soviet Union. But 33 years ago, he lost a fight to Rocky Balboa.
Because of you, I lose everything.
Drago represents revenge. So now he's blaming his entire self-destruction on Rocky.
But now he's trying to come back onto the world stage. And he has to use his son to get there.
Ya peligro. No tiene peligro.
So we're coming to America to put on this fight against the Adonis and confront Rocky to let him know that you did this to me, now that I'm going to do this to you and your boy.
My son will break your boy.
Más adelante iremos conociendo más de los personajes y la nueva historia de Creed 2. Y ahora, vámonos al mundo de Disney, ya que en mayo regresa, sí, regresa, regresa el genio, pero ahora en versión humana, con Will Smith. Estoy hablándoles de Aladino. Aquí vamos a presentarles un nuevo detrás de cámaras que nos cuenta un poquito de lo que vamos a ver en esta gran producción de Disney de este año.
So, it's about 6 a.m. We are in the desert filming Aladdin. It's absolutely amazing.
Aladdin is one of those perfect stories. You don't know how you know every word of the songs, you just do.
Aladdin is obviously a Disney classic.
You want to stay true to the original, but you also want to give people something different.
The colors and the spectacles and the songs, it's this rush of adrenaline. It's just so magical.
Al regresar, te presentamos un vistazo exclusivo de Glass y cómo fue hecha la escena de la bañera en el regreso de Mary Poppins.
Estamos de vuelta, estás viendo Más que Cine. Recuerda que nos puedes seguir en nuestras cuentas en redes sociales. Búscanos en Facebook, en Instagram y también en YouTube bajo Más que Cine TV. Allí vas a tener diariamente toda la información de los estrenos y noticias de la pantalla grande y también puedes participar por boletos para ver las películas del momento. Pero vamos a continuar. Y una de las historias de este año es Mary Poppins, que ha tenido una excelente crítica y también taquilla. Pero hay una escena clásica que vamos a presentarles que nos cuenta cómo es la magia del cine. Ustedes verán ahí lo que pensaban que era algo hecho por computadora, fue hecho totalmente real. Vamos a verlo.
Off we go. Some people like to splash and play. Can you imagine that?
20 Echo, take one.
Okay, guys, here we go. Everybody set?
I'm on.
And playback.
In our film, taking a bath, which children loathe and hate, becomes an adventure.
And in you go.
We all discovered the magic. The bath was covered with bubbles. This amazing special effects team had created a slide on the bottom of the bath. I think Mary's greatest quality is that she has this ability to bring magic to these children's lives.
It was really fun. I would do this every single day if I could.
Impresionante esta película y el arte visual lo sorprenderá. Si no la han visto, vayan a verla. Y continuamos con nuestra cobertura de Creed 2 y lo que vamos a ver ahora es un reportaje para conocer el personaje de Bianca, interpretada por la actriz Tessa Thompson, que es la novia de Adonis Creed. Vamos a verlo.
Bianca, she's someone that really has her own agency, and you see that reflected in her music.
In this film, they wanted to have their own careers and passions, but learning how to have love together as well.
So we really followed her journey and what's the next step in her relationship.
Bianca supports her man through and through, but then I think when she gets a look at Drago, she's like, oh boy.
I don't want to be that person to stop you, but I don't want to end up alone.
Bianca understands why he feels like he has to take the fight.
I'll beat him, but I need you.
But she's incredibly conflicted because it's a huge risk.
It's not just us anymore, D.
And this one, it really is like she's in the ring with him.
Come on, baby.
Si a usted le gusta el terror, también llega a los cines esta semana Escape Room.
Yeah, I'm here for the Escape Room.
When we first enter, we think it's just a game.
Mike.
Amanda.
When does the game start?
I think this is the escape room.
It's starting right now?
Yes!
But we very quickly find out it's not.
Oh! How do we get out of here?
Airline 451. I got it!
Talk about immersive.
What's wrong with you? That was real!
As we go on, each room triggers a different person.
One code for six people.
Where did that come from?
As we progress, we notice weird coincidences.
This is my hospital bed.
Me too. They knew everything about us.
They made these rooms for us.
Who would do this?
You can't leave until we finish our game.
Fight!
It blends both that traditional horror storyline with this more psychological storyline.
They're watching us. They know every move that we're making.
It's terrifying. You're constantly trying to figure out how to get out of here before the room kills you.
Surviving is a choice.
Esta semana viene cargada de estrenos y tenemos otra película que llega a cartelera. Y se trata de Glass, una cinta que ha demorado un poquito en llegar, pero finalmente la tenemos aquí y cuenta con la actuación de James McAvoy, resumiendo esa trilogía de las películas presentadas por M. Night Shyamalan. Los comentarios han sido algunos positivos, algunos negativos, pero usted es el que tiene que decidir si le gusta o no cuando vaya a verla a la sala de cine. En este reportaje conocemos un poquito más de esos personajes que hacen la historia de Glass, una historia que no se pueden perder.
My name is Dr. Ellie Staple, and I'm a psychiatrist. I understand that the three of you think you are superhuman. I am here to discuss the possibility that you are mistaken.
Dr. Staple is a woman of incredible compassion who has a deep-seated belief that her way of thinking is an answer to some of the world's problems.
I've been given 3 days to treat you by whatever means necessary.
The facts you are basing your belief in are wrong.
I suppose I saw her more as a statuesque figure. She's got a lot of sensitivity and empathy for her subjects.
Dr. Ellie Staple specializes in patients that believe they're comic book characters. This is the continuum of belief, of delusions of grandeur that has existed over time because comic books have become this incredible obsession in the world.
It's a very fine line between her clinical manner and her need for order and her ability to become incredibly connected to the person she's talking to. Like classical mythology, these stories are about gods amongst us.
Everything extraordinary can be explained away, and yet it is true.
He's still very calculating. He's still strong in his conviction.
He's changed over the years.
That question of good and evil, what a villain is and what a hero is really powerful.
It's a really interesting way to use the comic book world. What happens when you really have a belief that you have superpowers and that you might be superhuman? And don't we all sort of secretly wish, or maybe even secretly think that we do? Your friends and family members have lost their perspective.
You really dissected him, Doctor. Good for you.
Más adelante, más información del estreno de la semana, Creed 2. Y el elenco de La Gran Aventura Lego 2 nos cuenta de la nueva canción que no podrás sacar de tu cabeza.
You could make your house a home.
Estás viendo Más que Cine, gracias por acompañarnos. Y ahora vámonos con una película que muy pronto hace su debut, falta una semana. Estoy hablándoles de Lego Movie 2. Lo que vamos a ver ahora es conocer un poco detrás de cámaras cómo hicieron la nueva canción A Catchy Song, una canción muy pegajosa, que seguramente les quedará grabada en su cabeza.
Subject her to catchy pop music.
This is a song that will get stuck inside your head.
I
I've like heard it one time. I'm like going to be singing that for the next 2 weeks.
Oh no, are we in a musical?
I hate musicals.
What? I can't hear what you're saying. I'm too busy partying.
It's so catchy. My body is squirming. I didn't know I knew how to do this.
That's how you up. Everything is awesome. That song.
Estoy seguro que muchos están esperando esta gran producción. La próxima semana les tendremos más escenas y detrás de cámaras. Pero ahora vamos a terminar nuestra cobertura de Creed 2. Y lo que vamos a ver es un reportaje sobre su protagonista, Michael B. Jordan, que hace de Adonis Creed. Y seguidito, un reportaje completo sobre esta nueva entrega.
En este filme, queremos explorar Adonis being humble. And then being reborn and becoming the man he really wants to be.
Adonis has to figure out that what you're fighting for is something bigger than just yourself.
Creed versus Drago. This is the fight the whole world wants to see.
Adonis feels like he should avenge his father, but Rocky's afraid that history is going to repeat itself.
He's dangerous.
I'm dangerous.
He has a daughter now who he has to come back to because he's not going to repeat his father's mistakes.
You can always relate to an underdog story who's fighting for something, who has passion.
It's very emotional, and the action is there, the fights are there. I think we found the right combination.
Bianca Taylor, you're the only person I want to share my moments with.
We got this. We got this.
I was really excited about building on these characters that we were so familiar with and in relationship with Bianca and having that evolve, which is really, really important to Adonis and his evolution as a boxer.
But if there was the central theme to this film, I think it would be family.
Hey. There's so much emotional stuff going on both sides.
Victor Drago, son of Ivan Drago, who infamously killed Apollo Creed, appeared today to issue a challenge to Adonis Creed.
Ivan Drago, he's sitting on this pain and anger towards the world because 33 years ago he lost a fight to Rocky Balboa.
Because of you, I lose everything.
So Drago wants to win at all costs, and he has to use his son to get there.
The only thing that Victor wanted was to actually get the respect and the love of his father.
And I think Adonis has always felt like he had something to prove. I gotta take the fight.
He's got nothing to lose. When a fighter ain't got nothing to lose, he's dangerous.
But you don't think I could beat him?
Rocky realizes all he has is Adonis, and he's afraid that history is going to repeat itself.
I'll beat him.
You better.
Spouses of boxers is a team. The concept of we versus I.
So when he goes to fight, she's in the ring with him.
Keep your hands up!
The family element is important to Adonis, and Bianca is on board. Rocky's on board. His mom is on board. And everybody's fighting Drago.
Por supuesto, allí lo vieron, Sylvester Stallone regresa como Rocky Balboa y es el eje central de esta gran producción. Ese encuentro de Rocky y Van Drago debe estar muy interesante. Ojalá que se dé en esta película. Ustedes vayan a verla. Con esto terminamos esta edición de Más que Cine. Nuevamente les recuerdo, estamos en Facebook, Instagram y YouTube buscándonos bajo Más que Cine TV. Hasta una próxima edición desde Ciudad de Panamá. Yo soy Alex Medela y esto fue Más que Cine.